Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. While you can use 3ds Max standard lights with V-Ray, but it's recommended to use V-Ray lights for accurate results. Types of V-Ray lights: plane, sphere, disc, dome, mesh, IES, ambient, and finally sunlight. In this basic V-Ray light tutorial, I will be teaching you V-Ray plane and V-Ray sphere light. While for other lights, I have separate tutorials in my playlist. Plus, I will put their links in description. This basic V-Ray light tutorial is aimed for beginners. What you will learn: V-Ray light parameters, how to control V-Ray light directionality like we do with these barn doors, how to light using textures. So without any further ado, let's get started. First, I will discuss V-Ray plane light, also known as rectangle light, and then V-Ray sphere light. To create V-Ray plane light, you have three options. I like option 3. Click the V-Ray plane light button and drag it in the left view. The V-Ray plane light, also known as area light, is a planar light source. Now, open render setup or press F10. Change view to renderer from left to V-Ray cam 001. And click lock. This way, 3ds Max will only render this camera, V-Ray cam 001. Click render. By default, the light renders in the arrow direction. What do I mean by this? Just look into the viewport. Currently, the arrow is towards the right side. So, the lighting is also towards the right side. Next, start interactive rendering. Select the light and rotate it 180 degrees. You can see the light has also rotated 180 degrees. Now, select the light and rotate it downwards 90 degrees. Since the arrow is pointing downwards, so the light is also pointing downwards. Now, we will learn V-Ray plane light parameters. Select the light. Go to Modify panel. Enables turns the light on or off. Uncheck to turn the light off. Light on. Multiplier is simply the power of the light. The higher the number, the brighter the light will be. Color. When the mode is set to color, you can change the color and the light will emit that color. Mode. When the mode is set to temperature, the color of the light is controlled by Kelvin values. Change the value and see the result. 3000, 5000, 9000, 6500. If you want to know about the Kelvin values, simply go to your browser and in the image type Kelvin values and you will see the values along with their respective colors. Now let's discuss units. Units are important, but I'm not going to go deep into it as it can be confusing. For beginners, change the unit from default to radiant power. And remember this one important principle. Smaller light produce sharp shadows, while big light produce soft shadows. Let's see an example. Change the length and width to 1 and render. Look, the shadow is sharp. Save the result. Next, change the length and width to 8 and render. Look, the shadows are blurry. Save and compare both results. Length and width 1, sharp shadows. Length and width 8, soft shadows. 1, sharp shadows. 8, soft shadows. If you want to know more about soft shadows and unit types, then watch my tutorial Create Soft and Hard Shadows Using V-Ray Light in 3ds Max. You can find its link in the description. Targeted. When enabled, a separate target object is attached to the light source. It is helpful in placing lights. You can see it here. I can simply target any of my object and the light will move towards it. How to control light directionality? Close general rollout and open rectangle disk light rollout. Make sure your light is also selected. Change your preview from never to selected. Start interactive rendering. Left click here and choose this. If the directional value is 0, the light is spread out equally in all directions, as you can see here. Save the result. But if the value is greater than 0, the light makes the light be more narrower and concentrate in one direction. Let's see an example by increasing directional value. This example demonstrates how the light changes when directionality value is changed, ranging from 0 to 1. When the value is closer to 1, the light is more focused towards one point, while when the value is 0, the light is spread out in all directions. 0, 1. How to light using texture maps? If you want your light to light like this, then select the light, go to Modify panel. Click on No Maps and select a bitmap. Now render your scene. Currently, my texture is not proper. Press Cap to cancel the result. Open Material Editor. Left click here and drag it in your material editor. Make it instance. Rotate your light 90 degree and render again. Now my texture is perfect in the display. But if you see here, it's not proper here. Press Cap to cancel the result. To make it proper here, you have to increase your directionality to 1. Increase it to 1 and render again. The image that you load in your No Map can be an alpha or a color map. It depends on the result you want. Hopefully this is clear to you. Now we will learn options rollout parameters. Double-sided. When checked, the light is emitted on both the sides. You can see here. If I'm going to rotate it, you can see the light is emitted on both sides of the plane. If I uncheck it, the light is only emitted on one side. Invisible. When unchecked, the light will show in render and refraction when directly seen by the camera. But when invisible is checked, the light will not show in render and refractions, but it will appear in reflections. Affect reflection. If you don't want your light to appear in reflections, then uncheck effect reflection. Affect specular. Determines whether the light is affecting the specular of the material. This means glossy reflections. If I uncheck it, you can see there is no glossy reflection here. Affect diffuse determines whether the light is affecting the diffuse properties of the material. Uncheck it. Since we have turned off effect diffuse, specular and reflection of the rectangle light, therefore the render is totally black. Turn them on one by one and turn off only if necessary. Now we will quickly discuss V-Ray spare lights. Again, the V-Ray QA spare light can be created using these three methods. I like to create it using the V-Ray spare light button. It is a light in the shape of a sphere. It is good for lighting scenes to simulate real world point light sources such as energy saver, bulb, etc. where the light is emitted from one point and spread in all directions. V-Ray sphere light is just like V-Ray plane light. All the parameters are same. Instead of length and width, it has radius to increase or decrease its size. Second, it has no directionality parameter because its light is spread out in all directions. I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. If you like this video, give it a like. If you love it, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating, guys. Bye bye.